Where did you get that?
In the woods behind the house.
No, you didn't.
Okay, I didn't.
Go on.
Be warned. By reading this, I will hasten the release of the spirits that wrote it.
That's kitty crap.
As you wish. As the moon moved behind the clouds, Isaac reached the entrance to the witch's lair. Deep inside, he could hear the screams of his brother, Levi.
Help! Please, Isaac!
The moon reappeared, breaching the forest canopy, and Isaac knew if the legends were true, he only had until dawn to save his brother. The witch would steal Levi's voice, turning him into one of her shades, dooming him to an eternity of bondage. Years before, when she was still a woman, the witch had died giving birth. She found no peace in the grave and rose to claim the child she had once lost. Unable to let go, her unrest had turned her into a monster, and she took the soul of every child in her path until she might find her own. Isaac began running, but this caught the attention of the shades, and they began closing in on him. He turned this way and that, only to fall over a pile of decay, where he found a torch. He sparked his flint and thrust the torch's flame into the face of an approaching shade. It exploded in a cloud of fog. He turned his torch on the others, and soon he was advancing again. Levi let out a garbled plea just as Isaac broke through the fog to see the witch ripping the voice from his brother's throat. She pushed it into a box strung around her neck, and the whispers of her victim swirled around her. Mortified, Isaac cried out his brother's name. The witch spun her cold visage on him, her eyes black as pitch. In a flash, she was before Isaac, knocking him back over a stiff corpse. He shoved the torch into her face, but to no avail. She opened her mouth, releasing a rush of whispers, extinguishing the flame. Frozen with fear, Isaac stared into the witch's hideous face. He looked at the box hanging from her neck, knowing what had to be done, but too afraid to do so. The witch's claws tore into his throat.
That wasn't scary.
Good. Then you have no problem sleeping tonight, all alone, in the dark?
No problem at all.
You know how Mom died, right?
In an accident?
That's what Dad told you.
Because it's true.
No, Frankie. Mom died giving birth to you.
No, she didn't.
Yes, she did.
You're sick.
Why don't you have any memories of her? Why have you never seen her grave? You killed her, Frankie. Nobody was ever going to tell you that. Her body was too grotesque for a funeral. Dad had to bury her deep in the woods.
You're lying.
You don't have to believe me.
I don't.
But have fun trying to sleep tonight.
Real. Only a story. Lying. with me. Alex, wake up! Alex?
Why did you do this, Frankie?
I didn't know. I'm sorry.
I warned you.
Please, Alex, I'm sorry.
Thank you.
Here.
What's this?
Open it.
What is it?
Just open it. The address is on the envelope.
But
I'm sorry, Frankie.